Hi, Wendy Townsend here from 98 Rock, and I am here with Turnstile, origin Baltimore. However, one of you is an Ohio native.
Thank you.
And just like the Cleveland Browns, we stole them.
Oh.
Yes, that's right. The Ravens are now one of the best teams in the NFL. And we took you, and then we took one of the best musicians.
Yeah.
That's all we do is we take from Ohio.
Oh, good. I love these guys.
Thank you guys for doing this for us, by the way. I'm very lucky. I play the most new music on 98 Rock. I'm very fortunate. And we play Turnstile all the time. You're beloved here. You are so beloved here. How do you feel about that?
We love it back. It's like, absolutely. Yeah, you know, it feels good to be, especially tonight, like playing at home. It's always a good feeling.
This has to be amazing. This is like home base for you, right?
Oh, yeah.
And you just, now you're opening for Blink and White Reaper. You're just like, this is amazing. I'm like obsessed with this hat. Look at his hat. Can you pan on his hat? I keep saying that. It's amazing. So is it different playing at home? It has to be different.
It's a little different. I mean, it's at the very least, it's like the guest list gets bigger. You know? Mom and preach. And dad.
Preach.
And cousins. And
everyone is friends. Like, hey, how do I get in? Hey, yes, can I get access? Hey, is there going to be a Kardashian here? That's my biggest question already.
But honestly, though, it is kind of like, it's always you want to do your best, like make the best show happen. But like when you're here and I know. My mom is watching the show. So I'm like,
is your mom here?
She will be.
That's amazing.
Elevated tonight.
Well, first of all, I think it's adorable that you're like, I'm elevating it for my mom.
Yeah. Yeah.
However, when you started out, not at this obviously very large venue, you're so successful now. What was the grittiest, best like dive that you've done here?
First show?
Our first show ever. Like,
where was it?
At the Sidebar.
Sidebar?
Yeah, yeah.
First show ever.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, I swear.
Sidebar. Yeah, shout out Sidebar. Right. Still open. Still doing
no
well.
No way.
Yeah.
Right now.
I thought you were going to say Autobar, honestly. I really thought that you were going to go. Have you done Autobar?
Autobar was the big leagues.
Yeah.
Like, really?
Going to shows and playing shows, that was like maybe one day, but probably not.
Really? That was big leagues?
And yeah. That first
Autobar
day came
is
recently,
Autobar
actually.
Is big for up-and-coming bands that are not cover bands, and I love that for you.
High Key, we played there like
a week ago.
Yeah. That first time we ever played at Autobar.
All right, so typical band question, what is your favorite song to play?
Don't Play.
Mm.
That's the name of a song, by the way.
I know that.
For anyone.
That's why I was like, okay, I get that.
Antagonist.
Favorite song. But I know that musicians technically don't enjoy the hits. Like John Mayer's big on that, Mariah Carey's big on that. What is your favorite to play?
I mean, I love playing them all. Playing music with them is top three favorite things of all time. I think the one song that I wish that I played more, but I'm glad that it's chilling, is Generator.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's your favorite?
Right now in the set, it's probably Fly Again. Yeah.
Hey, what's your favorite?
Maybe New Heart Design.
Mm.
So funny, because you have these bangers, and none of you named the bangers. None of you. Right, you guys, obviously, because you're...
That's what we
no,
like, not
right. No, I know, because
likes.
You're musicians, and you love the work, and I understand that completely. And that's my T-Mobile phone. I hope that's... Yep, yep, that's what we're doing. Oh, please. It's probably my dad. He's a little too proud and gross.
Far?
Yeah, my dad's so proud. Sorry, Dad, I love you. No, but I just think it's funny because what everyone else like ingratiates with you is you're just in a whole different, you're like, no, this is the best stuff.
Yeah.
I like that. Real quick, when you found out you were doing, you got radio play, how was that for you? When you went from band, original music, which is hard, to radio play, like what was that moment like for you?
I just got on the radio trying to catch it for real. Like, I've been so ingrained in just like checking out not radio-ness. Like, it definitely made me like just check the radio, not out of selfishness, but like if they're playing us, that's new. Like, what else is being played that's new?
I can
check it out. So I just gave the radio a little bit more attention.
I will say this, my program director, Rick. Hi, Rick. He loves you guys.
Awesome.
Yeah, he's a big fan. Yeah. What was it like for you?
I think it was just a full circle moment, because growing up here, it's like we had 98 Rock, DC 101, HFS, all like the
How old are you? Do you remember HFS? You look like you're 21.
Of course.
You look like a baby.
Hearing on those stations in particular, because it's been on lots of stations in the country, but those ones, those hometown stations in particular, it's
yeah.
Like, kind of full circle.
So do you feel, obviously you're doing very well and you're very talented, and you just feel like this is my moment, like these are the things I grew up with, and this is like where I wanted it to be. Is that how you feel? Like, I wanted to be on 98 Rock. I wanted to be on HFS. Like, this is where I wanted it to be.
I mean, honestly, I don't think anybody was, like, shooting for that. Like, we were just, you know, respecting our music and each other and just, like, trying to be creative. And
how did you, how did all of you meet? May I ask?
Place playing music together. I used to just ride with him and his other band, and they grew up together.
What was your other band?
It's called Trapped Under Ice, also from Baltimore.
Okay.
Drums. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, I mean, I think all of us just kind of met through going to like hardcore punk shows in the area growing up.
I'm gonna do very gossip talk right now. Do you guys ever like fight? Get like tiffy?
Never.
Together? Like between, no. Between ourselves?
No, do you fight with strangers?
Yeah, all the time.
Oh, yeah, strangers for sure.
I'm kidding. Each other? No, like way. Obviously with each other.
No, no.
There's no differences here. You guys just mesh. That's it.
These are my guys.
Oh my God. First of all, adorable. Just, cut the camera.
Yeah, for sure.
I love this. I love this for you.
Yeah, it's easy.
Have you ever played here before?
At the arena?
Definitely yeah.
No. Nah. I feel like this place just got built again.
It got revamped. How nervous are your bellies? Like, no?
I mean, anytime their parents get to see us play, like...
Are all of your parents here?
Most of our parents
are your parents here?
Not mine, no.
Well, yeah, I'll be your parent. You have the cutest dimples, so I'll take coat.
Nah,
they
gotta stay down south, but... We playing for parents is just like any sort of atmosphere. We get to do that, whether it's an arena or auto bar.
How disgustingly proud are they of you?
I don't know. Hasn't ended yet. We'll figure out after.
Oh, tonight. You stop! First of all, you've already made it here. This show is going to be so easy, so kind for you. They have to be proud that you're here. This is your moment.
We'll approach it like that.
I love that. Well, thank you guys for taking the time against this beautiful paper wool. Thank you, Wendi from 98 Rock, Turnstile, CFG Arena!
Yeah. Oh, yeah.